Welcome back to HighLevel Techie. This is Jitin here, and today we are going to talk about custom objects and association. So this is just the beta version, the first look of custom objects and association. So this is going to be a quick video, and we are not going to go in depth about it. But the good news is that HighLevel has just released the association for its custom objects to the beta group, and we are testing it out. So let's see what it means and how you can start using it when you get access to it, right? So now you can see on the screen, we have two custom objects. If you want to see how it was created, there is another video, and there is another video that talks about custom objects in depth. So now we have created two custom objects. One is called students and one is called cars, okay? These are just for testing purposes. These are not connected to each other in any way. So let's go into the cars custom objects here, right? So if we click on cars, this is where you actually create the custom objects. Once you create the custom objects, you get access to these associations. When you click associations, this is where you can build that relationship between two different objects, right? So if you don't understand what it is, let's go in and see how we can create an association, right? So click here to create an association. And now you can see I can connect a custom object called cars with other objects that are available inside my account. So I have now available students and contacts. Contacts is the main object of any CRM, and student is the custom object that I built out a few weeks ago. Now let's think about a use case. So we are talking about cars and a contact associated to that. So for example, you're running a garage and you have so many cars coming in and you want to associate the contact who brings the cars in as the owner of the car. And this owner can have many cars and we want to track that association. So that's what we're going to do now. So first thing would be to connect the cars to a contact. So that's why we are going to select contact, select an object to associate with, and we are associating with contacts. And we have to name the association, and you can use a single label or a pair of labels. Sometimes a single label can be a bit confusing. So I would suggest, at this point, I would suggest use a pair of labels. So for example, if you select single label and if you select this owner as the label for this association, you can see here, many contacts can be labeled as owner and many cars can be labeled as owner. This kind of doesn't make sense now. So I would suggest we change that to pair of labels, right? And now we are talking about cars. If you go to a contacts record and that person has a lot of cars connected to him, in one column, there will be a lot of cars listed under that particular contacts record. So what do you want to call that? That's what basically they are asking here. So let's say, let's call it contacts cars. And under contacts, what do you want to call? Let's say owner the car or cars, right? So when you go further down, if you read this, many contacts can be labeled as owner of the cars, yes. And many cars can be labeled as contacts cars. At this point, HighLevel is allowing us to create only many-to-many association. I mean, if you don't understand that, I would suggest you check out one of the previous videos. So what it says is that many contacts can be labeled as owner of the cars. If you have one car and using this type of association, you can have multiple owners under the same car. Similarly, if you have one contact, he can have multiple cars under his name, right? This will all get a bit more clear when we go to the next step. So you can see here a car associated to many contacts with label contacts car and a contact associated to many cars with the label owner of the cars. So this kind of helps you to understand this easier, but when you are actually building out, you probably use shorter labels, something like that. Anyway, let's click save. We have created a new association. Now, to see this association, what we have to do is to go inside the contact record. So now we have created this under custom objects tab here. If you have access to it, you will see that. At this point, this is in beta. You wouldn't see this tab just yet. So let's go back to our main dashboard and let's select this cars. So I have created two cars here. So you can create any number of cars. So let's see, I have created a car called Tesla here. this car has its own custom fields and stuff. So you can add custom fields if you want. So for now, we have the car name and make and VIN number, registration number, etc. If you want to add more fields, you can do so by going into the settings. But the thing that we're interested in is here, associations. If you click here, you can see the associations that we can set up in here. So these are some of the associations that I was testing out. So don't have to worry about that for now. What we have to do now is to go into contacts and connect a contact to this car. So let's connect a contact. So I have so many persons created in here. So let's call person F as the person of this car. And here you get to choose one of the relationship that you have created. So if you have multiple associations that you've created, and you get access to all that. So I'm going to select the one that we created just now, the owner of the car. So now what we have done is we have selected a person and connected that person as the owner of the car by selecting that specific relationship. And now when we click save, a relationship will be made. You can see here, it successfully created a relationship. And what happens now, if you go to this person, this person's contact record, you would see a tab here called association. You can see the object that this contact has been associated with. He is associated with a car, and that car is Tesla. Now, if you want to know more about the car that he owns, you click on this Tesla, and then it will be taken to the Tesla record. This is where you can update the car details. And then if you go here, you can see all the people who owns the same car. So person H also owns a similar car, person F also owns a similar car. So this is how you create that association. Now, for example, say you are a car rental company, you want to track all the people who are renting a specific car. So let's go and see how that can be done. Okay. So let's go into settings and custom objects. And we are going into this car. And what we are going to do now is going to create a new association. And this association would be connected to contacts. And we are going to use a pair of labels and cars. We are calling rented cars. So if you go to a contacts record, you would see all the rented cars that that person has rented out with a specific company. And under the contacts, you call them person rented. And we are going to create that association now. So you can see the association has been created. Now all we have to do is to go to a car, for example, like someone comes in and they want to rent a Mazda. So we go in to this association and we are going to add that person who is going to come and rent. So let's say a person A is going to rent it, and then we select the association that we want. And this is the person who rented this car. So we select that. Person A is the person who rented this car, and we click save. Now, on another day, someone else comes in and they also want to rent the same car, which is Mazda. What we do is person B also rented the same car, because it's a rental company. Multiple people can rent the same car, right? So we do that. And then what we do is we just go into this Mazda record. And if you look at the relations, and you can see the contacts are number 3 now. So these 3 people are part of Mazda. And if you look at this person, H is actually the owner of Mazda, but person A and B has rented this car. So this is how the association works. I'll give you one more example. So if you go to person A, and what happens is that this guy comes back again, and but this time he's renting a different car. So we can do that. We can select a car for him from here. we can add him under Tesla, and we can select that this is the car that he rented, and click save. Now you can see under his record, he has rented two cars, one is Mazda and one is Tesla. So now imagine a situation where this is like a rent to own scheme, and this guy has actually rented Tesla long enough that now he owns the car. In that case, what we do is we go in here and change that association to contacts. Now he's the owner of that car, okay? And that association changes. So now what we've done is associated with contact object, which is the main object of a CRM. But we can also associate a custom object with another custom object. So let's go and see how that works. Okay? So we go back to our custom object. So this time what we are imagining is this is like a driving school and we have students and cars, right? So let's go inside a car and create a new association. If you want to see how we can associate from a different object, I'll just do it students now. Okay, so let's create an association here. This time what we're going to do is we are going to associate a student with a car. Okay, and in here, we are going to go with a pair of labels again, students and cars. So what we are going to do, so this student is using a certain car to learn how to drive. Okay, so let's call this student who a car. The car should be car used by the student. Okay, so this would give you a better understanding because of the descriptive label that I'm using now. But when you are actually building, maybe probably select something shorter. So let's click save. And we are going to our student object. And we have one student for now. I was testing with something else. So now this student is interested in guitar, but he's actually interested in car driving. Okay. And there's a car and a student. So let's add this student into a driving program. And I have given student ID. There is no student name, but you can easily create that by going into settings, custom objects, students, and if you click here, you can add a custom field. It is pretty similar to how you add a field. You just go here, single line, next. Let's call it student name. And now the important part is selecting the right object. So here I have access to contact object, opportunity object, student, and car. So this is going to go on the student object. And that will be student info, and we are ready to go. Student name is added. Now if we go to, now if we go back, so student name is added here. Now what we want to do is go into the student. Let's call the student John Doe and save. This is how you can create a new record under a custom object. So once you created and updated the record, now what we have to do is to create that association. You click here and you can see I've already been testing, so it's already here, but now the student is selecting a different car to learn, which is a Tesla, and we are going to select the right relation. So we are going to select car used by the student. So Tesla is the car used by the student, and we click save. So now we have connected this student to a specific car for driving. And that is accessible here. Now if you want to go and see the details regarding Tesla, we go in here. This will pull up all the details related to that custom object record that we have connected now. Okay, and then if you want to see the relation, you click here. And then you can see that person H is the owner of the car, and person F is also a co-owner of the car, let's say. So there are multiple owners for this car in this case, and there is one student who is currently using this car to learn. So this is how you can connect multiple custom objects with each other and create that sort of association. This is the First look, this is the beta version and we are still testing. So I just want to give you the news while I'm testing it out. So hopefully I'll come back with more news in the coming days when more and more features are added to custom objects and ready for testing. So if you have any questions related to what you've seen now, please let me know. So that's all for today. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.